G'day folks, in this video I'm going to show you how to play Summertime by Mr. George Gershwin, of course. I'm going to show it to you in a fingerstyle interpretation, and then we're going to walk through the chords and walk through the melody. And I do have some freebies for you. You can download a chord chart for free and a backing track to play along with for free. Just click the link below, and I hope you enjoy those freebies. I also have tab to my entire arrangement of this song, which starts in F minor and then ends in A minor. It's a pretty elaborate arrangement, but every single note I play in the arrangement is tabbed and notated, so you can check that out if you want. It's available at musicnotes.com, but the link to that specific tab is below, so check that out. Let's jump into it right away. Summertime. So we're going to look at it in the key of A minor. And I'm going to walk you through the chords before we go into anything too intricate, because I think the chords are the important underpinning of this song. It just repeats this sequence over and over again, and it's a great chord progression, so let's learn it now. One, two, three, four. So you start off with an A minor 7 chord, there like that. The frets are 5, 7, 5, 5, 5, 5. And like I said, there's a free chord chart with chord diagrams linked below, so do take advantage of that. A minor 7, then we go to a B minor 7 flat 5. That's also called a half diminished chord, and many people would be familiar with this shape, which is 2, 3, 2, 3 on the middle four strings of the guitar. That's a B minor 7 flat 5 chord. But I like to play it in this inversion, using my thumb of the left hand to play the low B. And then we're playing F, B, D, and A to fill out the rest of the chord. So the frets are 7, 8, 9, 7, 6. That's a B minor 7 flat 5. So it's like a B minor with a flat 5. There's actually no 7 in that inversion. I guess that's a more proper inversion. But I like this one. And then we have E7 flat 9. So we have an E7 chord. E, G sharp, and D. And then with a flat 9, that F note added. So the frets are open. And then 7. 6, 7, 6. And that chord repeats quite a bit in the song. So far we have A minor 7, B minor 7 flat 5, to E7 flat 9. And you can just repeat those three chords to create a cool kind of bossa nova type of thing. There, we go back to A minor 7. We play this chord, which is an A7 with a flat 9. It's kind of a little bit like a diminished chord. So we have an A in the bass, and then we have the A7 triad spelled out, G, C sharp, E, and then on top we have a B flat. I should also mention on my Guitar Synergy channel, I have a full lesson for this song where I break down the song in probably more detail than I'll have time to go into in this video. But that chord is an A7 flat 9. So the frets are open A and then a G, sorry, frets, 5, 6, 5, 6. I spell out the frets because everyone requests I do so. I don't think of them in terms of frets, I think of the note names. But however you learn the chords, it doesn't matter, it's good to learn them. So that's an A7 with a flat 9, and the flat 9 is that B flat note up top. So far this is the first line of the song, refer to the chord chart. It's free. Okay. Then we go to a D minor 7 chord. And that is 5, 7, 5, 6, 5. We hang on that for 2 bars. And then we go to the B minor 7 flat 5. We've already learned that. To the E7 flat 9 again. Okay, so we've learned the first 2 lines of the chords. Then we repeat A minor 7, B minor 7 flat 5, to E7 flat 9, back to an A minor 7, and then we have this turnaround which is called a 2-5-1, D minor 7 to a G7 to a C. So this kind of tonal center of this song is around C major or A minor. A minor is the relative minor to C major, and if we were to go to the 2 over C major, we get a D minor, and then to the 5 of C major, we get a G, and then we have C major. So it's 2-5-1, D minor 7 to a G7, and then to a C major 7, and I'll spell those chords out for you. D minor 7, we've already learned, 5-7-5-6-5, G7, bar chord, which is 3-5-3-4-3-3, and then a C major 7, which is 3-5-4-5-3. C major 7 to A minor 7, and then B minor 7 flat 5, and then we have this chord, which is an E7 sharp 5. So we go to the 5 of E, B, and we sharpen it to a C note. So we're just basically adding a C note to an E7 chord. So like an augmented type sound. So we have 7, 6, 5, 5. Okay? And then we just have the ending, which just goes to A minor, and then to E7 flat 9, like we've already learned. That's the entire chord progression. So I'll go through the second half once more. And with my right hand, I'm really just kind of using my thumb and my fingers to just try to play a bit of a... That's kind of what I'm thinking. I'm thinking of the kick drum. So when we're playing the fingerstyle arrangement, which I'm going to go into in just a moment, basically what I'm trying to do is play the melody. Over the chords. Play that, we first learn the chords, which we've already learned, and we learn the melody. Now I'm going to teach you the melody in a very simple way, and I encourage you to download the free backing track attached and play along with it, because it's a great groove. It's a great tune. It's a great melody. And this is a great song to just work on your phrasing, pulling all the beauty out of the guitar that you can. So the melody just goes. And so it goes E, C, E, which is 5, 5th fret on the B string, 5th fret on the G string, back to the B string, and then we go, and the living is easy. So we go D, C, D, E, C, A, E. Once more. Play that over and over and over again until it just becomes really locked into your fingers. But it's 7th fret of the G string, then 5th fret, 7th fret, 5th fret of the B string, and then 5th fret of the G string, 7th fret of the D string, 7th fret of the A string. And you can play this with a pick, you can play it with your fingers however you'd like. I'm playing it with my fingers just because I'm kind of approaching this with a fingerstyle type approach. So far we have. And then we go. So we play the same couple of notes to begin with, but we resolve to that D note, 7th fret of the G string. So it's E, C, D. You can play it twice, Fisher jumping. And we go C, A, C, A, C, B. So the second part. And then we repeat the first part. This end figure. And that's it. So the ending goes, hush little baby. It goes G, E, G, A, C, which is 5th fret of the D string, 7th fret of the A string, 5th fret of the D string, 7th fret. And we go slide up to E, D, C, A. So the melody from the top. 1, 2, 3. Once you've learned that, you can learn it up an octave. Doing a few little slides, especially on that little blues note, flat 5, and doing some vibrato, maybe a little bending. Anyway, it's great to practice your phrasing playing a simple melody like that. Now let's break down the fingerstyle version. 1, 2, 3. Thank you. I'm improvising a lot of this song. So if you listen to my performance version, which starts in F sharp minor and then ends in A minor, you're going to hear a lot of improvising. And you'll see the tab is probably slightly different to the way I'm breaking it down now. I'm thinking about it the same way, but every single time I play this song, it's a little bit different. So you'll just have to bear that in mind. And I think that's it's a good thing to be a little bit flexible and a little bit just understanding that that's how you would approach a jazz standard like this. It's not meant to be played verbatim. It's not a classical type piece. Okay, so what I'm doing is I'm playing this melody within that A minor chord. And I'm using my thumb to play the low A note. And I'm actually not playing the bass note on the downbeat. I'm playing kind of falling in on the upbeat. I don't do that very often, but it kind of feels nice for this melody. And then we walk up and we play the melody within this B minor 7 flat 5 chord. And then we play just a straight E7 because we want to get those melody notes in, which is D to E. And then we play this A melody note at the same time as the A bass note. And then I play this little fill. But before we do that, I'll just break down what we've done so far in a little more detail. So we have. Real slow. Backbeat here, kind of on the 2 and 4, but it's not super intense. It's just a real subtle backbeat because I just want the groove to be felt, but not really for it to sound like you're slapping the guitar too much. So that's the first little phrase. Now this little riff, you could play that melody note up top, but all I'm doing is double stops, hammering on in the third fret to the fourth fret, hammering on to the fifth fret on the B and G strings, and then back down to 3 and 4. Walking down the scale to an A and a C, to a G and a B, ending on an A7 chord. So that's a beautiful change going from the A minor to the A7, which is a nice way to build in, going to the D minor chord. Okay, so far we have. Started the same, but we go to a D minor chord this time. So it's kind of like a blues. Going to the 4 minor, or a 2 minor if you think in C major. And I like to just do this little walk up to a D minor 6 type sound. I think that's just a really beautiful little phrase. So what that is a D minor 7 chord, and then the pinky's just walking up the melody from A, B, C, E, D, and over this chord I'm playing kind of like a D minor 6. So the notes B, F, A, and D. Frets are 9, 10, 10, 10, but then the pinky comes on the 12th fret of the high E. Okay. And then I go. Is higher. Okay, So for that B minor 7 flat 5 chord, I'm not playing the pinky, I'm just playing B, F, A, and the open B, which is, that's the melody of the tune. And then you can really play any lick, kind of like a harmonic minor, A harmonic minor kind of thing, going to an E7 type sound. I like to play this lick. Kind of sounds Spanish-y. So it's pinky, D, C, and then hammering on. And then just playing like an E chord, but just hammering on to that F note. It's like the jaws. Type sound. And then we repeat the melody. And then we play this turnaround. And we can play really any 2-5-1 series of licks there. I don't know. I'm always just trying to play melodies, to be honest. You'll have kind of more intense jazz players who will give you all kinds of theory about the 2-5-1. Basically, just going from a D minor to a G7, you can play any kind of riffs you want that keep within the scale. Something like that. Resolving to a C, to an F, okay? So, what am I playing over the 2-5-1? Thing. It's just basically arpeggiating that D minor chord, and then doing a G6, sliding up to it. So it's G in the bass, pedaling, and then we have G, B, and E, 5th fret, 4th fret, 5th fret, and then we play the high E string 3rd fret, G note, and then we just slide that whole shape down. So it's kind of like an F with a G in the bass, which is a nice way to resolve to that C chord. And within the C chord, we're going to try to get that melody out as we move from C to F, and then to B minor 7 flat 5, and then to an E. You don't really have to play a chord over it, you just play the melody. Resolve into an A minor. So the end turnaround once more. Fingerstyle arrangement from the top. 1, 2, 3. But I'm going to play it once more really slowly. Let me know in the comments if you have any questions. Please do leave a comment. It does help the algorithm. Please also like this video and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And like I said, do check out the free resources, the free chord chart, and the free backing track. The chord chart's going to really help you learn the chords quickly and see how it's all laid out. And the backing track is going to be great for you to play along with the melody. And don't forget, on my Guitar Synergy channel, I have a bunch more lessons on this song. So there's a lot more in-depth lessons on how to solo over it and all kinds of things. So also check out my Guitar Synergy channel. This song is located in the 6-part standard section with songs like Georgia on My Mind and different tunes. Okay, nice and slow.